The mainstream media and anti-Trump liberals, which are increasingly hard to tell apart, have taken a clear stance on the firing of Andrew McCabe. It was done out of spite, and proves just how vindictive the president has become. That's the narrative being pushed hard by the news media, after the deputy director of the FBI was officially fired by Attorney General Jeff Sessions. At first glance, it's easy to fall for that argument. McCabe was only a day away from retiring, which would have given him full federal benefits at the taxpayers' expense. Of course, missing in the back-and-forth vitriol over McCabe's firing, however, is an incredibly important detail that the media seems eager to ignore. It turns out that Donald Trump didn't randomly decide to show the deputy the director the door on a whim. In fact, it was the FBI itself which recommended that McCabe be terminated, and so did the Inspector General of the U.S. Justice Department. Attorney General Sessions announced the decision in a statement just before 10 p.m., the Washington Post reported, noting that both the Justice Department Inspector General and the FBI office that handles discipline had found that Mr. McCabe had made an unauthorized disclosure to the news media and lacked candor, including under oath on multiple occasions. In other words, officials would be derelict in their duty if they hadn't let McCabe go, especially after he leaked information and spoke unprofessionally under oath. The Post again confirmed that the FBI had recommended the firing after a DOJ probe found wrongdoing. His firing, which was recommended by the FBI office that handles discipline, stems from a Justice Department Inspector General investigation that found McCabe authorized the disclosure of sensitive information to the media about a Clinton-related case, then misled investigators about his actions in the matter. People familiar with the matter have said, the respected newspaper reported. If you listen to the media and the left, the Trump administration was supposed to just ignore the fact that McCabe misled the Department of Justice, and turn a blind eye to a federal employee's bad actions because he wanted a full retirement package. Apparently, taking taxpayer money out of the pockets of Americans and spending it on the retirement of a man who two government agencies recommended be fired is completely fine, but following through on an internal investigation is somehow over the line. It's worth remembering, too, that the director of the FBI and other deputies like McCabe serve at the pleasure of the president. Donald Trump had the constitutional power to fire the former deputy director for any reason or no reason at all. The fact that both the DOJ and the FBI both recommended that action is just icing on the cake. Since day one of his presidency, the media and Democrats have worked overtime to paint Trump as a conniving fool who is the nemesis of the FBI. In reality, the facts consistently show that it was the FBI which was deeply biased and colluding to undermine the presidency, not the other way around. At the end of the day, Andrew McCabe was an establishment player who had close connections to the Democrat machine. His own shady actions caused him to be fired, and in true leftist fashion, he's now throwing a fit because he won't be getting a free ride paid for by American citizens. Do you believe the media is purposely downplaying these facts? Scroll down to comment below. Like and share this video on Facebook and Twitter if you agree. Don't forget to support this channel by clicking on the donation link down below and subscribing so you never miss any of our trending reports. What do you think about this report? Scroll down to comment below. Now, if you are seeking the latest trends in fashion and electronics and gifts and more at the best prices, please feel free to visit www.atthismall.com. Once again, that is www.atthismall.com.